Turn that off.
Yeah. Let me just check nothing on fire.
Nothing's ever on fire.
This is work.
Are you sure about that?
Oh, if you work in this industry, you know about that. Social media, let's throw in love, lust, celebrity, change. The many forces that can impact any relationship are explored in the new romantic comedy, Sell By.
And we're proud to have two of the stars with us before their world premiere at the Inside Out Film Festival. Welcome so much to Scott Evans and Augustus Prew. Guys, thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having us this morning.
Hang on, my mic is dropped.
Uh-oh.
It's my head. A microphone disaster.
Malfunction.
We were lucky to get an advanced screening of the movie, and one of the things that I thought you get so right in the movie is that idea of social media and how it's so present in so many of our lives and eating up our time, eating up our realness with people.
I think it creates a vacuum where you are sort of curating the best version of yourself, and often that can be very detached from who you actually are. You know what I mean? So we kind of create these two different versions, and often the time you can't catch up with it. Do you find that?
Absolutely. Well, there's all those people always talk about, you know, me in real life versus me online or a post or
IRL.
Something. With filters and everything these days, it's sort of like you can paint the best picture of yourself online, and then you end up kind of living online and forgetting about the real relationships in real life.
Right.
Well, yeah, the big thing in that is the social media stresses your relationship. Mm-hmm. Right?
Totally, 100%. I think also the social media aspect to the movie, it sort of represents the success of my character and the power dynamic that creates between us. Or that, you know, initially your character was more successful, and then my character becomes more successful, and it's about the sort of changing dynamics and how people deal with those changes and the jealousy and the shifting sort of paradigms of a relationship, shall we say.
And it's interesting because we're seeing kind of three different relationships in the movie. You guys play a couple in the film, and then we've got a couple of other couples going through their own things. Who did you each relate to the most?
In the script itself, I will say the characters, I think, that we both played, we kind of...
They're pretty well cast, I'd say.
It's pretty true to life. It was just, I mean, in general, just sort of like reading the script when Mike Doyle, our director, when he sent the script originally and I was reading it, it was sort of just like, it's weird reading a script where the lead character is a representation of myself, and we don't see a lot of that in film these days.
I think it's a great cross-section of kind of society, though. I mean, every relationship is different, and every relationship has its own problems and things that are great about it and things that aren't working about it. And I think it's about sort of the universality of relationships rather than just a gay relationship. That's kind of just one aspect of it, really. It's more of an ensemble than that, I would say.
That's what I wanted to ask. Would you call it a gay rom-com or just a rom-com?
I think I would just call it a rom-com.
Well, and even the rom-com, I think hearing that term, it's a comedy, it's romantic, but when you say rom-com, it kind of like takes away some of the realness, I guess, of it. And I think what's interesting and relatable about this movie is that there are other films you see and other movies you see, and there are times where I'm watching, it's like, okay, I can relate to those characters, whether or not it's LGBT-centric or not. But this particular script is, you don't have to, our relationship in the movie, it's like, if you're not in the LGBT community, you can still relate to it. It's a real life problem.
Well, I kind of said that it's a movie that is beyond an issue movie. We're not talking about the issue anymore. It just is.
Which
you know?
Is fantastic. Which I think speaks to the world that we live in now.
Yeah, and Mike said that, you know, he very much wanted to cast two openly gay actors to play these characters. Mm. How important is it for you guys in your careers to find characters that are representative of the community that you live in?
The most important, I think.
It's really incredibly important. And you know, it's getting better. It's better than it was. And it's growing up, the only LGBT characters you saw on television were pretty much the cliches,
the sassy
best friend,
the
fashion designer.
One-dimensional characters.
And so getting to read a script where it's sort of like, oh, okay, there I am. It's very refreshing.
I think it's important for just moving forward. You know, if as a kid, as a young gay kid, if you see people that you identify with on screen, on social media, I think that is really important. It gives you something to work towards. It gives you something to, I'm represented. You know, I'm part of this.
Somehow there's a value associated with it too, 100%. Right? Like, I matter. Go ahead, Brian.
Well, with the political climate down in the States, how do you think this is going to be received? Has it changed or...
I mean, I hope well. I hope it's gonna look again. It's about representation, and you know, America is an interesting country, and it's kind of it can be the most progressive country in the world, and at the same time, a very regressive country. And I think, you know, what America always does do well is it's always a conversation, and I think this is movie will be a part of the conversation, and I think that's the best that you can hope for right now. And you know, we'll see how it all shakes out.
You're here as part of the Inside Out Film Festival, and it's you know, Toronto is a huge film loving city. We have the Toronto International Film Festival, we have Hot Docs, we have Inside Out. How important is it for you for this movie to be seen for that audience, and what did you know about Inside Out Film Festival?
This is you know, like you said, this is the world premiere tonight, which there's still tickets left. By the way,
they just released a new batch of tickets.
But yeah, this is when I was I didn't actually know much about the festival until we had found out about it, and I was reading up on it, and I was like, reading the films that have come here and have been seen here, I was like, oh my goodness, we're going.
And it's been going since 1991. I didn't know that. It's a really, really established. I've been here for TIFF before, and I love Toronto. I have a cousin in Toronto. Hello, Helen.
Are they watching?
They sure are.
Yeah. Right, and maybe you're going to run into Drake.
He's here for the
fingers crossed.
He's in town right now.
Fingers crossed.
Was he partying last night? Did he have another?
He was leading the party.
Down at Jurassic Park, we call it.
I heard that this morning. The Raptors, Jurassic Park.
Really amazing cast that you work with as well in this. Tell me about the ensemble environment on set.
So playful. Right. Such a fun, playful cast. I mean, everyone's improvising. You keep everyone on your toes. You know, Patricia Clarke's an iconic actress. Yeah. You know, amazing.
Well, you've seen it, so you know, like, the relationships between friends, I think, is very well depicted in this movie. And it's not all, it's kind of just there. And it's not even just the fun, playful back and forth. It's kind of like the nitty-gritty of, like, best friendships and having to tell your friends when something's going on in your life that you don't necessarily want to tell them, and you have to because you need that support system.
I think the audience should feel part of this friendship group. I think that's what makes this film so magic. You feel like you're the extra person in the group that's not on the screen. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think that's why this movie shines. It makes you see yourself in it, I think.
I will say this. Slapshots is the worst idea. You'll know what I'm referring to when you see the movie.
And peppers.
Yeah, the worst.
It was a rough day. My face hurt.
Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining us.
Thanks for having us, guys. And have a great time here at the festival.
Thank you. We will.
Subway makes its world premiere tonight at 9:30. The TIFF Lightbox is part of our Inside Out Film Festival. Head to breakfasttelevision.ca for more info on the festival, which is on until June the 2nd. More on BT after the break.